both of you. More than 250 Holocaust survivors gathered in downtown Chicago today for the annual United States Holocaust Memorial Museum luncheon. Rahm Emanuel was honored for his work in fighting anti-Semitism over the years, but in an emotional and energetic speech, Chicago's former mayor told hundreds in the audience that with hate crimes and dangerous rhetoric rising, this is a time not only to remember, but also to respond.
The museum is not just about never again. It is not about memory. It is about inspiration to act.
Without mentioning President Donald Trump by name, former Chicago Mayor Rahm Emanuel issued a powerful rebuke of the president's anti-immigration policies and rhetoric by drawing a parallel to the Holocaust.
Yesterday may have been Jacob, but today it is Jose. Yesterday may have been Saul, today it is Saul. Yesterday it may have been Herman, my grandfather, today it is Enrique.
Emanuel, who is Chicago's first Jewish mayor, issued a call to action. He said the audience at the United States Holocaust Memorial Museum fundraiser was filled with the most influential Jewish community in history, and he says they have an obligation to fight hate while remembering the atrocities of the past.
Are we going to accept a rhetoric at a time that tells others they're criminal, they're dirty, they don't belong, they're infesting? We have seen it. We know what it leads to. Because if you delegitimize and dehumanize somebody, you can do anything you want to them.
Emanuel was honored for his longtime commitment to the museum and to Holocaust remembrance. The memories are still fresh for 90-year-old Holocaust survivor Estelle Glazer-Laughlin. She was 10 years old when Germany invaded Poland.
Immediately, my life changed beyond recognition.
Her father was part of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising and was eventually executed in a concentration camp gas chamber. She escaped to America with her mother and sister and says she's disturbed by the current climate in the country. Anti-Semitic attacks in the U.S. doubled from 2017 to 2018, according to the Anti-Defamation League.
If it happened once before, it could happen again. That the price that we pay when we accommodate ourselves to tyrants, what it does to the conscience of a nation, what it does to love and trust. I think that the beauty of this country is the fact that America was the hope.
The theme of the luncheon was what you do matters, and Cardinal Blaise Supich says that starts with parents, making sure the value of humanity's diversity is learned at home.
Hatred so often that we see in young people is learned. It's not something that they have innately. And so we as an old generation need to tell our children exactly where prejudice ends up and why we always need to fight it.
And Tribune Media, the parent company of WGN TV and radio, was a corporate sponsor of today's luncheon. The money raised today will help keep the U.S. Holocaust Memorial Museum in Washington open and free to the public.
Powerful message.
And what you do matters, right? Those are words we should all remember.
Indeed.
Good to hear again.
Thanks.